We have our annual State of Kubernetes survey out for 2021. I wanted to go over some of my highlights. First of all, we always want to know the maturity of Kubernetes. Now, I think it's pretty solid from these survey results and anecdotal information that it is the primary way that people run containers in production. You can see that it's gone up to 65% of people using Kubernetes to run containers in production from 59%. Another thing that's interesting is as companies get larger, if they have 500 developers or more, you see that 78% of them are using Kubernetes to run containers in production. In one of our recent surveys, 67% of IT leaders said they're only focusing on things that have immediate business benefit. So does Kubernetes make the cut? I would say it definitely does. You can see that improved resource utilization, saving money and optimizing, and also upgrade maintenance, shortened development cycles, these are all capabilities, especially the third, that a business uses to get better and better at software and to free up resources to focus on moving pixels on the screen, actual business outcomes and value driven by the innovation that they have with their software. As always with the survey of a new technology, it's great to look at what the impediments are, the hurdles. Oddly enough, when you look at the second thing that developers say is difficult, at 15%, it's still having to wait for tickets and other sort of manual processes to get access to Kubernetes. Clearly, there's some room for improvement there because one of the points of using Kubernetes for developers is removing that barrier. Still, only 15% is pretty small. What's even more interesting is when you look at the top impediment, which is at 42% of respondents who are saying that integrating with new technologies and existing systems is a problem. It's up 35% from last year. As Kubernetes is used more and more for existing systems, it means that developers are integrating with existing services, backends, and other applications more and more. So I think this is why you start to encounter that as an issue. It becomes more front and center when there's less experimentations and less greenfield applications being done that don't have to integrate with existing systems. When it comes to operations, you still see the same thing year after year. Knowledge and expertise of how to do things, and also making sure that it's secure and compliant. To that end, another interesting result is the use of DIY platforms, people building and managing their own Kubernetes platform. That went down from 29% of respondents in 2020 to just 18% of respondents in 2021. Obviously, I'm biased working in the VMware Tanzu land, but this shows the reality of focusing on what matters with those sparse resources that people have. Building and maintaining your own platform isn't critical to what your business differentiates on. And indeed, there are plenty of viable options for just getting a distro of Kubernetes and not having to focus on not only getting it up and running, but ensuring that it's secure and compliant, and also maintaining it over time, keeping it upgraded, integrating with all the other ancillary things that you need to make Kubernetes successful. There is a steady rise in usage of those distributions, including our own, the VMware Tanzu editions of Kubernetes. There's all sorts of other things to look into of that survey. You can find the link to that down below, wherever you may be watching this. Or if you go to tanzutalk.com/videos, you can find the show notes for this episode and click on them to look at that survey. Also, as a reminder, I have a new book out, which you can get for free, all about changing your mindset to be better at digital transformation. Go to tanzutalk.com/videos to get a link to that and the survey. Bye-bye.